you should use a component library for your next project, and here's why. Component libraries allow you to move quickly. They give you accessibility, they give you a bunch of components, they give you layouts, they give you all sorts of things that allow you to build a project quickly and focus on the more important things, such as the code that drives the UI.
But I'm a Tailwind CSS purist, that's all I ever use.
I hear you cry. Well, let's talk about why you should still consider component libraries, even though you might be a purist. So why should you use component libraries? Well, let's go back to my example, right? So you have this new project here, and let's say it's your next top SaaS. And inside of that top SaaS, you've got a bunch of things, right? So here's your big idea here, and then need all of these things to build it out. Let's say you have 50 components, and those 50 components are built out around, some are state driven, some are just UI components, design system, and you've got all of these things that you need to consider for these 50 components. Now you have your 50 components, there's also a piece in the middle here. And inside of that middle is the rest of the things that you need to consider, right? So your next top SaaS is gonna need something like authentication. It's gonna need databases. It's gonna need an API. It's gonna need third-party services. So it's gonna need all of these things on top of just the straight components that you need to build, right? So you have all of this to build out your project. So you've got your idea, whatever it might be, your next project, your next SaaS, your next whatever. You've got to build out all of these components, whether they're state-driven, whether they're control components, whether they're just UI components, or they're part of your design system in general, part of your branding, etc. Then on top of that, you have to worry about all these other things. What am I going to use for auth? Am I going to use auth.js? Am I going to use Clerk? Am I going to use auth zero? What database should I use? What's going to be the best for this project? What API layer should I use? Should I be using tRPC? Should I be using GraphQL? Do I own both parts of this, etc., etc.? Then on top of that, you have third-party integrations. Do I need to build out webhooks? Do I need some sort of just-in-time API? And all of those things are a lot to think about when you're building out this project that you want. So what kind of third-party components or third-party component libraries am I talking about here? So if you're a Tailwind CSS purist, I'm talking about Daisy UI or something in that realm. So what is Daisy UI? Well, Daisy UI essentially just uses Tailwind CSS to build out project. Daisy UI basically takes Tailwind and reduces the classes down to easy manageable pieces to build out projects. So if we click see components here and we say, I need a carousel, for example, that looks like this, and I need the JSX, this is what it would look like for class names, right? So for class name, it would be carousel. And then if you need a rounded box, you just type rounded box. And then for carousel items, use this. Now, what's good about this is it allows you to build things very quickly, but still use layouts and everything else that comes with Tailwind CSS. So you could build out an artboard, or you need a drawer that looks like this. You can do that all with very simple class names, even though you're still using Tailwind CSS behind the scenes, allowing you to build quickly and still have that flexibility that Tailwind gives you. Then after Daisy UI, if you want a more premium tier, you could use Tailwind UI, which is from the guys over at Tailwind CSS. It is technically a component library, but with a twist. It gives you the components that you could possibly need, and they have a lot of them, from marketing to application and even e-commerce. So if we go into application, they have things like headings that look like this, and then you can see the code kind of looks like this. It gives you everything that you need that you can just copy and paste and then change based upon if you want React, for example. Here is the React version, and it gives you everything that you need, but you can tell based upon this that's using pure class names, so you may need to abstract those out, but for the most part, that gives you the same idea. You can take these and produce content quickly at a premium cost. Now, moving away from Tailwind for the purists, if you're a Tailwind purist, you can probably just close the video now, or you could like and subscribe if you're enjoying it so far. Now we need to talk about other component libraries. So if we go back to here and we talk about pure component libs, So what do I mean by that? I mean Chakra UI or Mantine, for example. Those are really good examples of command libs. What do they give you out of the box? They give you accessibility. They give you customization. They give you components. They give you the ability to override and pass props from other things. So for example, if you're using Next Image, you can pass the props from Chakra's image to Next Image to give you optimization, but still give you all the customization that comes along with it to style it in the way that you want. So let's look at Chakra UI and what it gives you for free. So for free, it gives you everything that you could possibly need to get started with an application. Now, obviously there are trade-offs here. There is going to be a slightly larger package when you build this out, but overall, you can tree shake, you can import in specific ways, and it allows you to build fast and easy components. Now, every single component here is completely accessible, allowing you to not have to worry so much about accessibility. It forces you to use the labels, and if you don't use them, it will give you an error message. So let's talk about it. One of the biggest things, at least for me in general, when I use component libraries is the ability to have some sort of layouts made easy and quick so that you can make more progress on the things that are important to you. And the things that are important to me is how things work. So here we have something like a container. This will wrap your content based upon sizes that you denote. So for example, you can set it by pixels, you can set it by container small, by medium, you can set them depending on what you want. You can center everything and everybody knows how important it is to center things. And then we can move on to things like flex, where it gives you the ability to do flex with just the word flex. And then depending on what you want to do, you can do direction and wrap and base and shrink and all the other things that come along with flex, but they make it as easy as possible. They make grids super easy, so if you're into grids and you need to use them, they have something called a simple grid, which is completely responsive. So you can use something called auto-responsive grid, which basically sets the min width and the spacing that you give, and it will shrink and move everything around based upon that template, giving you the ability to move quickly as possible. On top of that, it gives you everything from form controls, gives you number inputs, gives you everything that you need to build an application in one spot. And the big thing for me is accessibility. For example, here, it gives you the details of how accessibility works, how the keyboard navigation works, everything like that, so that users that need the accessibility have it. On top of that, they do offer premium, of course, same kind of thing, premium app. You buy it, you pay for it, you get all of these components. And based upon what you want to do, so if we go to application, because we want to build the next SaaS, maybe you need some sort of authentication. It gives you the ability to build things like this with specific themes for them. And these are obviously depending on what you want. They have one called handwritten, which I think is really weird, but it is an option. And it gives you the colors that you might need. But you can build something like this and just take the code and here it is. With every kind of JSX or TypeScript or JSX, depending on what you want, it gives you the ability to build quickly and worry about the important things, right? Databases, API, third-party services, all those things that are the challenging part that you don't want to have to worry about building a whole UI because you're building this next project. Finally, let's talk about Mantine. This is another component library that's built around being responsive and gives you the ability to move quickly. It's flexible. It allows you to build themes, CSS overrides, all the things that you may think that you need, but it will get you much further than zero. So here's an example of a navbar. It gives you two sections here. Here's the first section, here's the second section. You can look at the code behind and see how they're building out the code. And you can see here that there's a lot more CSS than say Chakra. And that's because they base most of theirs on CSS versus other component libraries out there. On top of that, they give you things like, here's an example of authentication. It's very simple, it's clean, it looks good. It has this responsive tag to let you know that by default, it is responsive. And of course, they give you the ability to customize it based on a few colors so that you can easily copy and paste this in based upon your brand. They also have something called hooks, which allows you to do certain things such as use pagination to allow you to do easy pagination. It gives you the way to control those hooks. It gives you the way to do siblings and boundaries and definitions. It gives you everything that you need to essentially build out very custom usage using just hooks on its own. They have other things that are excluded from the default core package. So the Mantan core is basically the UI library, and the hooks power some of that. You also have the ability to have forms by default, which gives you the ability to do some form control. It gives you initial values, all those kinds of things that may allow you to move a bit quicker. My point here is less about the fact that Tailwind CSS does everything and more about the fact that you as a developer are struggling to finish projects. Using a component library allows you as a developer to get to the point. Worry about the complex systems behind what is controlling that UI. Then in the future, when you have the MVP and it's finished and built and you are testing it and users are enjoying it, you get to make that technical decision whether or not a UI library is fine, a component library is fine, or I need to go back and redesign the UI using something like pure Tailwind CSS to allow my users to have a better experience. If you did enjoy this video, make sure you hit that like button, make sure you're subscribed, and I'll see you in the next one.